Welcome, this is Patrik from the Watchbox studio in Dubai. We are here at Dubai Watch Week and I'm joined by Edouard Meylan, the CEO of H. Moser & Company. Thank you for being here.
It's my pleasure.
Very good. I have to start straightforward.
Wow.
In the industry, because I come from the industry in the past, you have a bit the name of being a wild child. And this comes because you're very creative. I was always amazed of what you do. I'm talking about the Swiss Alp watch. I'm thinking about timepieces which were created by flowers and plants. How do you feel about having this kind of reputation?
Well, I like the idea of wild, a little bit less about child, but you know, I mean, I heard many times maverick, and yeah, I think there's a little bit of that. To be honest, I feel every brand goes through kind of life cycles, and since we took over Moser, you know, you have to find your space. It's a little bit like you're in your teenage, and you need to emancipate, and you need to tell people what's your identity and find it yourself. And I think that's a little bit what we went through. There's a lot of things that are important to us that we value in terms of tradition, in terms of craftsmanship, in terms of things we believe in, and we felt there was a special way to express it through our communication, through our products, that might be different from what people usually do. Is that a bad thing? I don't think so.
I think we have to
live with our time, and we tried things, and I think it worked pretty well for us.
Now discuss with us the challenge of finding that niche, I would call it, for a brand in today's world, which is actually very traditional. How did you overcome, or how are you overcoming that challenge?
I think there's this fear for a lot of people of not pleasing everyone. And I think that's what we're trying to do every time with Moser. We need to polarize. We need to find a singularity. We need to be different. We need to find something that you cannot compare. When I took over Moser, I loved the product. I felt, you know, the finishing, the quality of the craftsmanship, the movements were amazing. Why do people not buy more of those? Mm-hmm. And then you come to realize that people would put the Moser next to, you know, the biggest brands on the tray, and the watches would look quite similar. Probably better finishing and better features on our products, but they were too similar, and people end up buying the well-known brand. So all the work after that was to find our identity. How can we make it different so that you don't even compare? You like it or you don't. I want people to love our product or hate our product, because those who love are ready to spend $25,000, $30,000, $40,000 on a watch. And then about the identity, as you said, we're very traditional. You know, we are integrated. We do our hairspring. We do everything in the movement. But we don't want to be boring. We don't want to create traditional, elegant watches that our grandfathers would be wearing. We want to have something that talks to ourselves. I think I have quite a young team, and we wanted to bring this sexy, you know, modern touch in our products. And I think this is this tension between modern and traditional that makes Moser special.
I fully agree, and I talked to somebody early this morning about you, and the person said to me, he thinks that you're a defiant, you have a defiant respect for tradition. And me personally, when I look at the product, I see there's classic in there, it's traditional, but there's a piece of sex appeal in there. Yeah. How do you feel about that statement, defiant respect?
That's exactly what I want people to see. Every product might be a little bit different, but that's always what we say. I mean, using sexy, we cannot do that in every country, but it's exactly what we want to do. We say we're traditional with an edge. And being the color, being the material, being, you know, sometimes playing with new technology, this is what we want in every single product.
When I go into your website, I see H. Moser very rare.
Yeah.
What do you mean with that?
Well, many things. I think very rare is what we are in the sense of being independent, family owned and run. There's not many. Very integrated. As I said, we do our hairspring. You know, you can count on one hand the number of companies who do that. We actually supply about 25 other brands, including some of our good friends, you know, like MBNF and stuff that really praise the quality of our hairsprings. And that's very rare. Of course, it's also about quantities. We do a lot of small editions. We have a production of 1,500 watches, not available everywhere. I see here a lot of people coming and say, oh, do you have this one? Oh, I've been looking for the Palladium Green. I'm like, it's been 2 years, we don't have any more because there were 20 made. Mm-hmm. But that's what luxury all about, you know. Mm-hmm. It's about exclusivity, things you cannot find everywhere. We're trying to protect the value of our products. I tell my team we like investment bankers. We have to make sure the value of our products remains as high as possible over time. So when some people tell me, why do you stop this? I said, because I think it's the right time. I want to stop at the peak and not at the lower mm-hmm. point. And that makes Moser very rare. I think our communication is also very rare because it's in a way different. So yeah, very rare is the cornerstone of what we do, and it explains a lot of the things that we make and who we are.
I would like to pick on two products, maybe the one which you're wearing today.
Yeah.
And the first one, I always had a special interest in perpetual calendars. You just launched a new perpetual calendar with a double window.
Yeah.
Is there anything you can tell us about this?
Very controversial. You know, in the watch industry, when you change something, you know that, you have strong reactions. And we have a community of huge fans of Moser. And a lot of people say, you know, I know what Moser is. And I'm always asking them, so tell me, because, you know, I'm still figuring out. Mm-hmm. And Moser was well known for this small arrow in the center yes. of our perpetual calendar. Everything at the center, the most minimalistic perpetual calendar out there. Extremely successful. We sold a lot, and it's still one of our hot sellers. But what I came to realize, especially in the last few years, there's a lot of people who don't see that small hand. Actually, you don't really need it except when you set the months, but there's a lot of people, they want to see the months. So we said, okay, we're going to do special editions where with an evolution of that movement using a months indication with a window. And we created those two pioneer with quite nice dyes. One is a burgundy, almost raspberry color, and the other one is funky blue. And very successful, just attracting other people. But we had some of our hardcore fans like, what are you doing this? This is not Moser. Probably they're right, if you take really the essence of what Moser is. But,
well, but I mean,
sometimes you need to open a little bit to other things. I think there's a straight line, and you need to be ready to do a few things on the side.
On the other side,
also other people discover.
On the other side, you can say Moser is also, you can read it.
Yeah.
It's about readability. It's very easy to read.
It's clean. I mean, we're working on a chrono. It doesn't look like a chrono. It's everything at the center, and that's going to be also. It's impacted by the philosophy of the perpetual calendar. And I like to say, perpetual calendar is a dream to have it in your collection. It's a nightmare when you're developing new movements because you're always compared to that particular caliber. But that's good because that means it forces us to think differently.
What are you wearing today?
I'm wearing something actually that we haven't launched yet. It's our heritage center second funky blue. I mean, a lot of people have been asking me, is this watch going to come out? Because we launched the Tourbillon earlier this year. Great success. Heritage is a collection that is inspired by what we have in our museum. A lot of the watches that we had from the early 20th century transformed pocket watches, big crown, Arabic numerals, which is not typical Moser as we know Moser today. We brought in this particular model a new technology, which are ceramic Luminova numerals. Each numeral is molded individually in ceramic charged with super Luminova.
Exactly.
So you have a very three-dimensional numeral lighting up at night with a funky blue dye. So what you were saying about tradition, this is very antique in the case, shape, even though there's a lot of details on the side. But the dial is very sexy and using high-tech ceramic technology.
Yes.
So that's exactly what Moser is. It's this tension between those two worlds.
In today's world, and this going on for many years with all the CEOs in the watch industry, they talk about innovation.
Yeah.
What is your take about innovation in general or with regards to H. Moser?
Well, innovation is always a good thing. I think innovation in product, innovation in just the tools we're using to be today connected. I think if there wasn't something like Instagram, I don't know where we would be with Moser today. I mean, 7 years ago, we were very early in understanding, grasping this new world of social media and create specific content, be very active and think about it as not as just throwing pictures at the face of people, but engaging people. And I see these innovations a great way for us to connect to other human beings passionate about what we do. And it's what luxury is also, is having this relationship and meeting people, shaking hands, talking about products is what we love. And Instagram helps us, or other WhatsApp, media, etc., helps me and my team being in direct contact with those people around the world. And I think we have a human family size that allows us to do that. And I think part of the success that we had in the last few years was that, is having people in the team ready to go the extra mile, to satisfy, to answer the customer. There's a problem, I get all the emails that we send to info@hmoser. And then if it's, you know, a question about whatever, I send it to sales team. Is there a technical problem or something? I usually answer directly. And I think that shows also the credibility of the brand. We take it seriously. I think every customer has to be very respected. It's so difficult to get the name out there. So when people know us, we want to make sure they're happy with
and
what
that
we
you
do.
Stand
and that's
behind
service.
The brand.
So if innovation can help service, that's a great thing. In terms of product, there's many ways to innovate. As you know, it's difficult to create new complications today because so many things have been created already 200 years ago. But we always try to find new things, like you know, being the Vanta Black dials that we have created, using a nanotechnology developed for the NASA, for the telescopes to absorb the light. Moser is known for fumé dials. I always had the frustration of saying, how do I make a beautiful black dial? I don't want it just a black dial like the others. And then finding this and knowing that Moser, we can do something with no branding, because that has become a little bit of our signature. Vanta Black was, or Moser was, the perfect brand for Vanta Black. And it's been a huge success. And people love the idea of having this high-tech nanotechnology on a very, very traditional watch, which actually using a hand-wound movement. So I think there's many, many ways to grasp innovation, and we need to stay open. We need to be creative. And
well, you are very creative. Also, when it comes to distribution, I would say, I just read a user-generated launch of a product. Can you tell us how that works?
Well, you know, we at Moser, we have a lot of novelties. We have a lot of those special editions that sell quite quickly. And we always say, you know, sometimes it's a bit boring. You just make a press release, send it to the journalist, and hope that they will talk about it. So we always think, how can we do it differently? And over the years, through the media we were talking about before, we started to have this huge fan community that we meet around the world that are great people. And we felt, you know, these are our best ambassadors. But there are a lot of people that tell me, well, you know, I live in whatever, Houston, or I live in I don't know which country, and I don't have a chance to see a Moser. So we felt, how can we get out to those people so that they once try it? And then we said, okay, let's try to do something different, which is just based on trust, organic, and it would be a consumer-generated launch. So basically, we launched the watch by giving it to two of our first, I would say, fans that we had out there, one from Thailand, one from the US, and have them wear the watch for 10 days, hand it over to their friend, whoever they choose. We don't choose. And then that person hold it for 10 days, and then it creates a chain of people based on trust. There's no legal aspect behind it, that it might be lost or stolen, whatever. What we want is that people who otherwise might not have the chance discover that watch and invite their friends and show it, feel it. So we use the Pioneer in steel with a DLC case, because we want something that resists, you know, over time. It's been great. It's been a few months now, and it's been in many different countries, a lot of states in the US, and it's going a little bit everywhere. Very and we cool. hope it continues. We set the limit of 12 months, but if we can go further, that would be great. And I get a lot of feedback of people saying, it's the first time I see it, it's so cool. And actually, quite a few people bought that exact same watch after having it on their wrist. So.
Very good. We are here in Dubai Watch Week. What is your feel and what do you think about Dubai Watch Week and the way exhibitions are developing in today's world, particularly in view of the end consumer?
I think Dubai Watch Week is, for us as independent and relatively small boutique brand, it's an amazing opportunity. The challenge for people to understand, to learn about our brands through our traditional communication is very high, because we don't have budgets to, you know, get our name out there in magazines, on television, etc. The most effective way for people to understand Moser is to get engaged with somebody like us or our team, etc. And I think the platform here where you teach people what is all about high-end horology, getting to meet the people, explaining them on a regular basis, because it's happening every 2 years. It's the fourth year I come here, and I see the evolution of knowledge of people about watchmaking, but also about our brand, is incredible. I mean, it's have been here, like meeting people that in the meantime have become almost friends because we meet on a regular basis. They all own a Moser. They come in and say, oh, you know, I saw this and you did that and I love this product. 4 years ago, I mean, I was happy if somebody had heard of us. And I think it's really a great education. People discover the complexity. We have a masterclass here where we explain how to make hairsprings. And there's one step where you need to put four wires into a small ring. And actually in 4 days now, nobody has achieved to do it. Mm-hmm. And some get very frustrated at some point and like, oh, I'm just going to go, it's impossible. And we have people, that's all they do the entire day. And I think people there realize the complexity of what we do. So I think that's an amazing formula. I wish it would be more like this in maybe in other with other fairs. The big ones, I think, are slowly moving towards more consumer-focused offering. Mm-hmm. I think Watches and Wonders is a good example of that. What they're trying to do around it, we can't forget that we still have to sell to retailers and wholesalers. So there's a part of that, but I think it's still important to bring something special to the customers over there. You were talking about our special initiatives where we create crazy watches. I see it a little bit as you know, when you go to the Salon de l'Auto, the car fair, or you go to Art Basel, you want to see something special. You want to see something different. You have all those concept cars. You don't want to see the standard thing that anyway you're going to see in the garage in a few months. You want to see something that is showing you the future. And that was also the idea of those crazy concepts that we show there. Is I want people to, you know, to dream, to think differently, to be inspired, to be, to see something they wouldn't see if they were going to a Sedicky shop on a regular basis. And I think the fairs are slowly evolving, and they have to do it fast because, you know, with big brands integrating the distribution, for those big brands, there might be less and less of a need of creating those platforms if there's not a real consumer focus.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
It was a pleasure having you. Thank you for watching.